Good morning, I'm Linda Ostovitz. I'm a Principal and Practice Group Director with Offit, Kurman.
Good morning, I'm Brad Blackwell, owner and distiller at Lost Ark Distilling Company.
So it's Friday morning at 10 o'clock. I'm sitting at a bar in a distillery at Lost Ark Brewing Company with the owner. It's quite a way to start a Friday, don't you think?
Absolutely. It's the way I start every day.
I was going to say, is this how you start your Fridays?
Absolutely.
Or every day?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, you might remember that I had the pleasure of being here at the ribbon cutting 3 years ago when Lost Ark Distillery opened.
Mm-hmm.
How did it come to pass that you opened Lost Ark Distillery?
Oh goodness, it's such a long history in the making. This started actually back in 2014. So I was a home brewer, making beer, enjoying that. And all through the years, I had all different hobbies, but home brewing was the one that always stuck. And then around that time frame, sure you're familiar with jailbreak brewing, owners were friends of friends. So we went over and took a tour before they ever opened, and I was doing research on breweries actually. And I just thought it was amazing to see those guys doing that and seeing all the other local breweries pop up. So I saw articles on the West Coast, actually, of craft distilleries. I didn't even know what that was. But I saw in Washington, for example, Washington State had close to 100 craft distilleries. I'd never heard of it in Maryland, so I looked and there were two.
Mm.
So clear discrepancy there. I started doing research and figured out maybe I can do this too.
So, you know, a lot of people have ideas about, gee, I'd like to start a business, I'd like to do this, I'd like to do that. Not everybody's got that entrepreneurial spirit or the fearlessness, or however we would describe that. So where does that come from in you, Brad?
Honestly, I've wanted to have a business since I was a kid. I don't really know why. My parents always taught me you could be anything you want to be. Ever since I was small, I just wanted to be my own boss. You know, for me, that was kind of like the pinnacle of being successful. Little did I know, right? I kept that inside my head all through the years. I never knew what it would be or when it would happen or anything like that. So I kind of saw this opportunity when I ran across, like we said earlier, the craft distilleries on the West Coast, and I had the skill set, and then I said, this is an opportunity. This is something I can learn. I have a background, and why not? Let's jump in.
So did you learn by yourself on your own, or did you have people teaching you, or go to classes? I don't know how you be a distiller. How do you do that?
I'm still figuring it out.
Okay.
We're all still learning here. So that's the cool thing about the distilling world is that it's so unique. And I honestly could take my recipe for my rum, drive down the street to the next distillery, make it on their equipment, and it would be completely different. So it's a tough industry to learn. But what I did was I took my brewing background and drove to every distillery I could get to 5 years ago, which there were a lot less then. Went to Kentucky, visited everything I could down there. And I actually flew out to Boise, Idaho. Spent a few days in a distillery out there doing hands-on work, kind of top to bottom. It was the best money I've spent by far in the business, and we learned everything. And that trip is when I said, you know, I can do this. I've seen it, I've done it, now we can do it for real.